Today's session we'll see two things. One thing is on the cube building part. Okay, so that one we missed out, which I'll cover that the very first thing, and then we will see some portions on performance tuning. We will just mostly we will discuss on one thing and what options we will discuss on what we have gone through till now as options of performance tuning. That is one thing, or what you have noticed out from the mappings what we have done. And then we will see something about how to implement parallelism in your transformations. Okay, so that technique is what we will see now. Okay, so the first thing, when you get onto your cubes, Informatica also supports cube loading portion here. Okay, so as part of cube, you can also load the data in that cube format which is there in your relational database and give the feed to the OLTP applications as a feed here. Okay, for that, how you do? First, you need to build your dimensions. Actually, if you see that in your folder structure, you will see something called dimensions cubes. Okay, so dimensions is the place. First, you need to predetermine saying what all you want to build in this here. Okay, so where do you do that? In your target, once you go to your target menu, you will see something called create or edit dimensions here. Okay, so the first portion is what we will do is we will create the dimensions here. So this does not give you any option of importing from your source or anything like this, but this has to be manually created when you create these dimensions here. Okay, so you can add a new dimension. Okay, then you can name a dimension, you can give a small description, and you can say where is the underlying database which has been connected to. Okay, all those options is what if you can give here. Say suppose I have my dim underscore cust. Okay, so this is my customer dimension which I have specified there. Then it will tell you what are the levels and what are the hierarchies you want to add to that is what you need to specify here. Okay, so as per your dimension table structure, you need to mention these levels and hierarchies in this. Okay, say suppose you have similarly like your date, time, location. So these are other things where you can keep adding on your dimension values here. Okay, so if you have a location, you will say location ID, location key, location name, and all those things. This again goes based on your dimension table definition here. Okay, then later you can come here. You can say add level or anything, add hierarchy, whatever you want, you can specify that. Once you say add level, it will tell you what is the level name you need to specify. Suppose say level is this is what this is date, right? So I will say as date key. Okay, that will be my level, and here in the columns there you can import from your source fields. Okay, so there you can define what is the source, what is the column, what is the precision, what is the scale. That is where you can import, or you can create from your on your own here. Okay, let's see a small example. Okay, I say I have some reusable code where I am giving it 1 second. This is create table dim location, so not this portion. Okay, so I have my location table only, right? In my we have our location table in our source. Let's take those as our location here. Let's delete of this. We will say we'll keep this as location. We will just say it as key. Okay, we'll go to that, leave this off. Okay, try to import it from your database, connect to the database, you have your dim locations. Okay, so select all those location ID, location, street, postal, city, whatever you have, you select those things as part of your things and add to your table here. Okay, So that becomes your location dimension things and specify OK. So in this hierarchy, when it comes or in this level, ideally this is one thing only, right? So sorry, it's not all I should give. It I should only give location key here. So rest I need to delete off. I need to recreate once again for them. Okay, so this is for my location key. I'm getting this from my thing here. Okay, then I'll add one more thing, and I will say location code. Okay, then I will re-again import that from that table again. So for each and every column, you need to keep giving these sort of things here. Okay, so you need to keep adding like this here. Okay, because these are at the levels for each and everything. So what happens is you need to keep adding that levels, and if you have any hierarchies here, you can define your new hierarchy. What is that hierarchy, whether it is normalized or non-normalized, that sort of, this all again depends on your OLAP structure. Okay, so how you want to design your OLAP feed, or if it is a normal dimension, you can give it as a normal dimension definition here. Okay, so that definition structure is what you will be creating here in this particular dimensions, and in this dimensions portion here. Okay, in your target, create dimensions, this location is where you will give those particular levels, everything on those things here. Okay, so once you create your dimensions, then what you need to do is you need to create a cube here. Okay, so you need to create a cube. You can specify a cube name and say where it is connecting to that. Okay, you can specify some cube, say sales load or sales fact, whatever it is there, you can give there like that. Whether it is normalized or non-normalized is what you can specify. Which database it has to connect when it loads the data, because this will be loaded as a target file to you, okay, not as a flat file. So if at all you need to connect to a database, specify which database you want to connect. So that is what you need to specify it here. Okay, once it is connected, again you need to check what are dimensions available, whatever you have created in the list, so those will come here. If you want to build any hierarchy from that, first you need to select hierarchy. If you don't have any hierarchy, just leave it off. Go to the dimensions, select the dimension values what you want to load into this from the source table here. Okay, say from my dim locations, if you say you need to add your location ID, that you need can give. Okay, if you say you need to get your customer ID, okay, say from your another customer tables, so that you can select. Okay, if you have any fact table where you want, you can select measures from there. Okay, so all those is what you need to specify on what measures you want to have in your fact here. Okay, like if you have salary, that will be one measure. Okay, then you got location, you got salary. If you want to say department, you can say department ID, that is another measure which you want. So select all the measures whatever you want to add to your fact table here. Okay, then specify the name of the fact table. Okay, so once you specify the fact table, and you will have the measures corresponding to that selected as part of your previous step here. Okay, you can create, add a new fact table, or you can remove the fact table, whatever it is there, you can do that. Okay, say sales fact. Okay, I don't know if I have any sales fact already here. No, I don't have, that's fine. I'll say the name of this as sales fact, and now once you say finish. Okay, so once you say finish, what happens is the cube will be built here. Okay, the cube will be built in the cubes portion, and the hard code target will be built for that cube in your targets portion. Okay, so in your targets also you will have something called as a sales fact, which will come and reside there. Okay, you can just save this. So once you save, it will get inserted into that. and it is later as simple as how you use your mapping. Suppose if you are using a mapping, you bring all your source tables here. You bring your dim locations, okay? Say m underscore cube load. Say I'm just giving a name for this. Okay, already exists, is it fine? So then you have your location cubes and all the other sources is what you will get from that. Where do you load this data? This target, whatever you have brought into this, you just import it into your mapping here, okay, and link your data accordingly. So location will become for your location what it says, data type decimal. Okay, I think data types are not matching, so just ensure those things matches there, and you need just need to map to your targets like this. Okay, so that is on how you can build the cube loading for this. So once you get that into this fact table, it is just a dump. What if you want, you can give that as a text file to or some dat file, text file. You can rewrite that to some other target or directly link this source itself to your OLAP cube. Okay, so that is how you can build your cube load here. Yes, go ahead. Yes, please.
When you are attaching to the different tables, does it become a join?
The rest of the mappings will remain the same. If you want to do some transformation in between, you can all use those, do that and link to your cube target here. Okay, so this
example,
cube also
attached like this. For example, here you have showed two sources. Okay, from those sources you have the common keys and you are attaching to the sales fact now. So
yes,
it automatically become a join?
No, it will not become a join.
So we have to use transformations.
You have to use transformations in between. No, I'm not telling the complete thing. I'm just giving you the overview.
Okay, yeah. Okay, like a source and target use only.
You can just use that as a target. That's what I'm just mentioning here.
Okay. Okay.
And again, if you want to use, you open this, you can go ahead and you can just double click this. You can see all columns, whatever it is, as normal way here. Okay, so the table now it looks just like a target table for you there. That's all. You can close the cube here. You need to close the cube. Sorry, first. Once you close the cube, then you can come back and you can edit the cube again. Okay, so you can come here and you can write this cube back here so that it will become in editable mode for you. The target designer only will be used for editing the cube as well here. Okay, so once you say edit cube, you can again go back, change your dimensions, measures. Okay, you can make respective changes here, what data types and all, if it is not sync and everything, aggregation. If you want, you can do some aggregation on your cube also. Okay, on your measures, this on your measures you can perform your aggregations. Okay, that's on that. You can come back, make those required changes and close that cube there again, close the target and use that in your mapping normal.